Hey, Cam, for business, mainly for social media. If you haven't met me before, my name is Victoria. Hi, welcome today. I have been teaching small businesses how to use social media, e-commerce, and Canva for quite a few years now, but I practice what I preach. I have owned multiple e-commerce businesses, but I've also owned bricks and mortar businesses as well. So I've sold them, bought more, sold them. I do tend to sit in the startup space and then sell my businesses. I've just started another business, a skincare range, and we are moving into the US. I already sell on Amazon in the US with another product. And we're moving into Singapore as well, and we sell on our own websites. I've also written 3 books on stress management, and I'm the local board member of our local Chamber of Commerce, Shopify and Facebook partner. I've got a Bachelor of Teaching, which is why I love coming here and teaching you, and Cert for in small business, and quite a few other little bits and pieces that I won't list. I do tend to love my learning, but most of all, I am a mum to 2 teenagers. So this webinar is brought to you today by Business Station. I'm one of the digital business advisors, and there are many, many amazing people, or there's 35 of us on the team, who have an expertise in a bit more of a niche. Like I said before, I'm social media, e-commerce specifically, Wix and Shopify and Canva, but we've got some amazing people on the team that specialize in other areas. So this is a great program. You get 7 hours personalized business mentorship for only $44. It is federally funded, so we need to make sure we jump on the program before anything changes. If you are eligible, you do need to have an ABN in Queensland, Northern Territory, or WA, and you need to be not registered as a non-for-profit, and either be a sole trader or employ fewer than 20 full-time staff members. Now, can I just put a little caveat there? We have now the ability to help non-for-profit in Queensland, and those non-for-profit actually get this program for free, for no cost. So if you are here as a business for profit, or you're registered for profit, but you have friends that have a business for a non-for-profit and they're selling a product or they are selling a service, please let them know about us. We really want to help as many people as we possibly can. So you can jump into businessstation.link/register and you can choose an advisor, or you can just ask us to choose an advisor based on your business needs. So what on earth is Canva? Canva is one of my favorite places to be. I spend so many hours, lovely hours in Canva. It's a graphic design program for people who aren't graphic designers. And if you didn't know, Canva was actually founded in Perth in Western Australia. It's owned by Melanie, Cliff, and Cameron. Predominantly Melanie's keeping it going. And she's actually, I think she's just been known as the third richest woman in Australia, but she gives so much of that away, so much of that. She recently gave it to the floods, the fires, and Ukraine. Very, very, I keep hearing amazing stories about how much they give back to the community. So it's a very easy drag and drop graphic design program for non-graphic artists. It does make us look very professional, even if we've got no idea what we're doing. It's fantastic. I started using Canva when it was a little bit clunky. It was new, and I must admit it was a little bit clunky, but there was nothing else out there that I could use anyway, so it was okay. So I feel as though I have grown with Canva and literally created thousands and thousands of pieces of imagery, ebooks. I recently created a website on it, and taught hundreds of people how to use it. So what can it be used for? It can be used for your social media. So any type of social media that you want to that you want to use it for. You can use it for resumes. I created my resume on there, no problem at all. Cards, you can even create print on demand. You can do t-shirts, you can do business cards, you can do brochures. And now you can also do websites. I'm not that sold yet on the websites, but I know that they do evolve quickly based on the customer's experiences. So today we're just going to be covering the basics, and depending on your level and depending how much time we've got, we can actually extend that out as well. If you have a very specific need in your for your business, let me know and we can go through that, or we can get together at another time and we can go through that specifically just with you. So we're going to go through all of the basic features of Canva, and then if we have time, we're going to go through a little bit more of an intermediate part of Canva as well, a few extra things that you can do that really do make your life a lot easier. Okay, so let's get into it. Jump out of that one and jump into this one. Okay, so this is what your Canva will be looking like if it was mine. What happens with Canva is it's very intuitive. It finds out what you like to do and what you like to use, and then it actually makes it easier for you to use. Like I said, I present in Canva, so that's the first one that's come up here for me. Then I do social media in Canva. I do a lot of videos in Canva, and I recently created some stickers in Canva. So do you see it? Actually, it's quite intuitive to what you need. You'll find lots of different ideas under here, and then you'll find your designs under there. Like I said, I own a skincare company, so you're going to see a fair bit of that. Up here on the left-hand side, at the top left-hand side, you've got your home and you've got your templates. Now, I really encourage you to go into Canva thinking about what you would like to create, because if you come into Canva and just think, oh, I'm just going to have a play and create anything, you can get lost and spend hours and hours and hours in here. So I actually really encourage you to say, okay, I'm going to create an Instagram reel, and then have a play at that, get very good at that, and then say, great, I know how to do that. I'm going to create a Pinterest post. And so you're not getting lost in amongst all of this, because once you've found that you want to create, say, a Pinterest post, you'll find hundreds and thousands of templates just in a Pinterest post. So it extends out even more than it does in here. So being very mindful about how you want to create and what you want to create. All right, so we're mainly going to be focusing on social media. When we come across here, we come across the features. Again, loads and loads of different things that you can find in here. I don't actually think I've spent any time in this little area here, but I wanted to show it to you so you can see. The next one along is Learn. Now, these are great Canva tutorials. I find them slow. I'm a fast learner. I can actually I read faster than people speak. And I find I want to put these on double speed. So these are great if you really are stuck and you need to find something a little bit quick and you don't have time to sort of learn it yourself, or just come and ask me. And I just wanted to let you know that there's lots and lots of different learning tutorials that you can do in here as well. Okay, so the first thing that we would do usually is come up to create design. So create design on the top right corner. And then you have a chance to scroll down and scroll through all of these little things that you can choose from. So we're only going to choose one, but I wanted to bring your attention to this little button that says import file. Now, previously to this, we used to have to change, if we needed to change PDFs, we needed to use Adobe or use some other program. this Canberra bought this in, gosh, probably about a year ago now, maybe less, but we can import our PDFs and then we can change those PDFs in Canva very, very, very easily. So if you know the pain of having to change a PDF previously, it was very tricky. All we do need to do here, we can import anybody's PDF. It doesn't need to be ours. We can import anyone's PDF. I want to remind you though, to be ethical and have very high integrity in your business and to not steal somebody's PDF and change it to be yours. This is a fabulous function for anybody who has a brochure or a menu or a sign that needs to be updated that is saved as a PDF. So we can go in there and we can just change, you know, we can, if your phone number has changed or if your menu prices have changed or if your opening hours have changed, this is a fabulous thing to be able to go in and just very quick and easily change that PDF and import your logo and import your information in there as well. So we can pop up here and we're going to be making a Facebook post today. So a Facebook post is either square or a little bit off. So I just clicked on Facebook post and it opens it up. On the left-hand side, you'll see hundreds and hundreds of templates that you can use. Okay, if you don't have Canva Pro, you can use any of these ones. I'll just scroll down so you can see one. This little crown means that it's Canva Pro and it's a paid one. So I do have Canva Pro, it's $17.99 per month. And you can use, you can have up to 5 people on your one Canva account. Now, I need to let you know though, that all of those 5 people can see everything you do and they can change it. So please be mindful about who you allow onto your account and you need to know that you trust them. Okay, so if we scroll down through all of these to try and find something that we really, really like, it will take us hours. So if we go into the search bar and we search something that is to do with your business. So we've got a person here that is in plants. So all I did was typed in plant up here and you can see that there is loads and loads and loads of ideas and templates that you can use. Now, you can use them. These are all for free. You can use them for free if there's not the little tag here. And if you have the free program, if you choose one of these that has the little crown symbol, you will have to pay for that one. So have a little play around it. If you find that you're paying for a lot of those things quite regularly, you might just want to look at going into the paid program. But if you are a non-for-profit or an education, you actually get Canva Pro for free. So let's have a look at one of these posts. So all I did was clicked it and it came over. Okay, so fabulous. We've got a post that we can use straight away, no problem at all. What I would do is I've come over to the image, I've clicked on the image. Now it shows me the text that we can use here. And then I can come up to the where it says rubric. So that is the font that is used here. So I just click the rubric. And then you can have a look and see all of the different fonts that are down here. I really encourage you to find a font that really suits your brand, that your customers can read very, very easily, that isn't isn't difficult to read when they're quickly scrolling through online. And have a look at that and see if you can just use that for most of your words. So do you see I clicked the font and then it gave me the opportunity down the bottom to change all. So I'm going to change all of those. So that just changed all of those different, all those fonts to that. And then I would go through and I would put in your website or your social media handle if you don't have a website. I'll possibly put in your local address if you are a physical shop. And then we can change any of these. So we click on it. Here is the colors. We can change the colors. Now, this is bringing me your attention to a brand kit. So we can change any of the colors up here. But when you have the Canva Pro, you can put in your colors. So if you have your own brand colors, and I really encourage you to do this, you can set this up in the brand kit in Canva so that every time you want to change a color, you have the chance to just say, okay, great, these are Business Station's brand colors. I'm going to choose that one. I'm going to change all. And it changes it to suit your colors and your brand every single time. It's exactly the same, which is very important for your brand awareness across different platforms. So if you have a brand colors on your website, please make sure that you've put the same hex colors, the same brand colors on your social media posts across all of the different platforms. So if you're Instagram, Pinterest, Facebook, and your website, and YouTube, wherever, making sure that you've got that color consistency across all of the platforms. The reason why that's important is everybody has been scammed online. So this is our way of building trust in our customers and our clients so that they can see a consistency across all of the platforms. Okay, so one way of making that easy on Canva is by setting up your business, by setting up your business's colors. So you can very, very easily change them every time you come in here. And then you've just got that beautiful brand consistency across your whole entire Instagram page or your Facebook page or wherever you are. Now, another little tip, and I haven't tested this on this one. This is going to be like, you know, when you go to the doctor and you were sick the day before and you're not sick that day. But we'll test this. A little trick that I found a little while ago is I found that, say, if I liked this person's graphic and I thought, geez, that looks really, really lovely. What I tried to do was find other pictures that looked similar until I found a little trick for you. So see on this graphic here, there's three dots on the corner of the graphic. If you click on those three dots, I hope this works. If you click on those three dots, you actually find the person that created the post here. And then if we click on that, we see that that person has everything that person has created. So you can see here that they've created another one with this board. I might add the page and create another post with that board. Wonder if they've done another board one. But right at the beginning, before we actually started, I'll just scroll up a bit, you can see that there's some similarities between some of the posts that this person's doing. These ones. So that's the same thing as when you go into the photos. You can choose the photos and see the person that took the photo, and then you can find out more photos that they've made. Okay, let's cross out of that. Okay, so what we did before was we went to plant. Another thing that you can do is look for other keywords. So your niche was plants. You might like to do something that is green. And then you'll find everything that, you know, has the green color in it. So you might like to try and figure it out that way. You might like to look at, what could we look at, Forrest? We've got lots of different things in there as well. The other thing that we can do when we're in social media is we can look at winter's coming up. So you're thinking of your social media strategy, and then you're just going through and you're trying to find templates that suit your social media strategy. So when you're thinking about a social media strategy, very, very quickly, you're thinking about four pillars of your social media. One of them is selling your posts, so selling your products or your services. So that's your face in front of a camera, talking to them, selling your services or telling people about your products or showing your products, and a call to action about how to get your products. The next one is inspirational posts. So they could be quotes, or they could be just things like this. Let's have a look and see if there is quotes here. Sure, loads and loads and loads and loads and loads and loads of quotes that you could do. So your next pillar of social media strategy is for quotes. Very easily to find a quote in here. The next one is education about your product. Where do we find your product? How do we get to your product? What's interesting about your product with skincare? I'll show you. I recently did skincare layers, how you actually put your skincare on. And so you've got educational posts about how to do that. So very, very easily to creating these in Canva. So you've got your product selling post, you've got your inspirational post, you've got your education post, you know, making people realize that you're the expert in the field. And you've got your entertaining posts. So they could be funny memes, they could be funny quotes, they could be anything that's entertaining. They could be behind the scenes. They could be, you showing off your puppy, making social media actually social. In amongst that, very, very important to do testimonials. So I'm just going through, types of things that you can do for your social media posts and how to create them in Canva. It's just showing you how incredibly easy it is to create these in Canva. So if we click on that one, we've got our testimonials. Fantastic. What you do on the left-hand side, you've got uploads. So this is you uploading your product photography or a picture of your service or the place where you do your business. And we've got lots of different things that we've uploaded. So let me try. This is a book that I wrote the other day. Anti-aging stress relief. So all I did was I uploaded that. I dragged it over into here. We can write a testimonial. Based on after somebody has read this, we can say, great, you can take that from your Google. You can take that from your Google testimonials, or you could take that from your TripAdvisor testimonials, or, any review that you have. These are very, very, very useful in here. So not only can we look up testimonials when we're here, let me just show you, there's literally so many that you can use. Mine is showing me skincare ones because this is what I create on here. Yours will become a lot more intuitive about the types of posts that you use. Okay. So I'm going to go up. Not only can you write in testimonials, but you can also write in reviews up here as well. And you'll get different types of templates for the reviews. So when you're looking at your social media strategy, really thinking about bringing in a testimonial or a review at least every fourth post. And so just use Canva and make it very, very, very easy for you. Okay. Now, another thing that we need to remember Social media is really, really, oh, sorry, Instagram and Facebook, specifically Instagram, are competing with TikTok enormously at the moment. So both Instagram and Facebook are showing animated video posts more than anything else at the moment. So as you would know, you've been in business for a while, social media changes regularly. I keep up with, or try to keep up with everything that's going on. What is working at the moment is video. And so you might say to yourself, how on earth do I create a video? A lot of people don't actually want to have their face in front of the camera. It's actually very easy to create video in Canva. So there's two ways of doing this. If we've got a review and we've put our review in here, so like I said, your review could come from Google, or come from TripAdvisor, it could come from your website, it could come from a text that somebody has given you and you ask their permission. Geez, this is great. Thank you so much. I really appreciate your feedback. Would you mind if I use that on social media so everybody else knows how much you how beneficial the product or the service is? So you copy and paste that into there once you've got their permission. I've clicked on this. Then I can come up to click on animate. Do you see on the top right? I'm hovering over animate. And then it brings up different ways that we can animate it on the left. So animating it makes it move, which turns your whole entire Canva into a video, which then you upload onto your social media and it shows as a video, which gets through the algorithms better. Okay, so what I did, I clicked on the words, I clicked on animate, and then I can come over and I can just, I hover over them and we'll see, I'll hover over one of the ones on the left and then it moves. Okay. I tend to use this typewriter one quite a lot because I'm just going to go up to rise so I can demonstrate this for you. So if I go to rise, you'll see how quickly it rises. Okay. It just very, very quickly rose. When I go to typewriter, it actually takes its time. People need to stay on that post to read to the end. That teaches Instagram and Facebook that our posts are interesting because people are staying on that post. Do you see how we can tweak things so that it can suit us? So I tend to use a lot of the typewriter. So all I did was click typewriter. And then when I go to download it, I click share, download, and you'll see that it comes up as an MP4. I would download that as a movie, and then it can be, then it, on a desktop, it gets downloaded to your desktop, into your downloads. If you're on your phone app, you download it to your camera roll. The Canva phone app used to be quite useless, I think, and now it's awesome. It's easy to use and it's simple. So a little hack that I do, I actually like to use Canva on a desktop, but everything syncs to my Canva app on my phone. So when I create things and put them into Instagram, such as an Instagram reel, I download it from my Canva app on my phone. It sits in my camera roll and then it gets uploaded into Instagram. Okay, so that's one way of animating your posts. This little button up here means undo in Canva. So I'm just going to undo that. Oops, so it's not animated. Another way of animating your posts is going onto the left-hand side, clicking on video, and choosing a video that suits your niche, your industry, and obviously suits the review that you're doing. So if we find one sufficient, easy to work with and meet deadlines, so we might just look at professional person. Let's see what comes up. Drag that over there. Might want to drag that so it sits in there a bit better. Let's play that. Up here, we can actually crop this video. So it only plays for, I'd only put it for about 5 to 7 seconds. So I've just moved that purple. So it just plays for that. Okay. Ideally, when you're creating some sort of testimonial, you will show you or you will show the actual product. But if you don't have something like that and you just want to create a video in Canva, that's how easy it is to do. You can even create audio over the top of that as well. Now, remembering that on Instagram and Facebook, you actually have to turn the audio on. And a lot of people watch the content with the audio down. So when you're creating a post with audio, just let it be a background feature. It doesn't need to be the full feature. And I wouldn't do it every single time as well. So if I was to use audio, it would be for something like if I was to do a happy birthday to a staff member, or if I was to do a Christmas post, something like that. So I'll just show you how to use audio on the left-hand side, click audio. And then you can search for all of these songs. Now, these are all royalty-free within Canva. So if you've got Canva Pro, you can use all of those. So I'll just show you, drag it over. And then you download that as an MP4. So you've actually got an amazing post that you can do. It's got audio behind it. It's got a video in it. And you are giving some a benefit, telling them how great this is to your customer. So very, very easy to create something very professional looking in Canva if you've got absolutely no graphic design knowledge. I'm just going to get rid of that. Okay, so we've talked about templates. So I'm just going to go over to the top left-hand side and click templates again. So that's how we really go through templates and try and find out ones that are going to suit our brand. Now, right at the beginning, I went to Facebook post. You, whatever template you want, you can choose whichever size you want. So if you're creating a Pinterest post, go to Pinterest post and create that. If you're going to Instagram Reel, create that. But there is another way that you can do this as well. If you feel as though you've created a fantastic post and you don't want to go and create the same one in a different size, we can use this little resize button up the top here. So if we click resize, we've created this post in the correct size for Facebook, but then we can resize it to be the preferred size for other platforms as well. Okay, so when I'm creating my posts, I tend to create an Instagram post and I make it animated or I put some sort of video into it. The Instagram post is the same size as a Facebook post. So I use that then. I use that same post for Facebook and Instagram. I then resize that post to Pinterest and I put it onto Pinterest. I then resize that post into Instagram Reels and put that size into Instagram Reels, Instagram Stories, and Facebook Stories. So I'm really only creating one piece of content for multiple platforms. So it really saves a lot of time. I also, I need to backtrack a little bit, I guess. What I actually do is create the blog first. So I create a blog, I create a picture for the blog that goes on the website, and then I create the Instagram and the Facebook, the Pinterest, based on that to move people over to the blog. Okay, have we got any questions? I know I speak very, very quickly. I just want to give you the most amount of information as I possibly can for you. Okay, so we are going, this is in templates. So I encourage you really not to get lost in here, but to go through and find ones that you really like. Now, let's go down to elements. It will show you the recently used ones. So that's quite handy because sometimes you just, I use very similar ones all of the time. So that's actually a really good thing to do. So you're not scrolling through everything to try and find anything. I use these lines and shapes all the time just to have a bit of a background behind words. Do you see how that stands out a lot more when you've got some sort of background behind it? If I don't like how opaque that is, I come up to these little transparency, click this, and just have a bit of a play with transparency, just see how light and dark I want it. If I don't like the color, I come up to the little square up here, click color. And then, like I said, I've got you, you've hopefully got your brand colors in there already. I'll click on the color. Now that's too dark. So I would then click on the words. I'd change the text color so it stands out. Okay. So just see how quite easy it is to be able to change bits and pieces as you go along and then just change them back. Okay. Margaret, I would like to have my design be viewed on the front and then the back being shown like a flip motion. On a social media post, Margaret? Front and then the back being shown like a flip motion, or in like a flip book on a Facebook post. I don't think I've ever seen that. I wonder if you can show me an example of it. Perhaps when we've finished, show me an example of it. And then the back, like a flip motion. You're intrigued me, Margaret. Oh, my brain is whirring. I'm trying to figure out how we can do that. I want to try it. All right, so let's have a little at the end we'll have a little play and see if we can figure that out. Okay, so when we've got our graphics here, we've got our stickers, photos, videos that we've been through, audio that we've been through. If you want to create charts, there's loads here. If you want to create tables and frames. Now, one thing that I do want to let you know, I'm just going to get rid of that. Every time that you see this picture, which is down here and down here on the bottom left, every time you see this picture, it means that you need to add in a picture or a video. So this is just the template that sits behind it. I did see somebody actually use that somewhere. And I thought all they needed to do was put in a photo. Okay, very easy. So that's the elements that we can go through. Now you've got your uploads. Now I just want to let you know on the left-hand side that yours may be in a different order, but these are all the things that you can do in here. So you've got your uploads. You can upload a photo, you can upload a video, and you can also upload yourself as you can actually speak into the camera and upload a video onto Canva. Your text. Okay, so if I wanted to get rid of that, I want to add some text. So you can add in a heading and then you would move it to where you want it to be. You would click on that. And then you would add in your text. Over here is your font. So choose the font that is going to suit your business the most and probably stick to it. So you've got that lovely brand consistency across. This is where you can change the size, or you can change the size by moving these in and out, the circles on the sides. You can also change the size by moving the lines. Let's move that, sits in the middle. Do you see how these pink lines arrive? So it shows me where to position the text so it's in the middle. And then you can change the color by clicking on this one. What should we change it to? You can change the bold, italics. You can change whether it sits in the middle, the alignment. You can put dot points in it. You can make effects for it as well. So let's click on effects. So if you want to create something a little bit more intriguing for your business, perhaps the curved text would be lovely for you. We could perhaps put that around Guasha, like that. Okay, so it's just, it just makes things very easy for you to create, to make it very, very cool. Okay, let's move that back. I just want to show you, getting rid of that. If we click on some of these, they can be really tricky to read for people who aren't perhaps gamers. So you have to know your target market very, very well. So if your target market are gamers and they read that pixelated text easily, fantastic, use it. But if your target market don't read that very well, just don't use it. Just use the normal text that you'll see and use that regularly. If you are going to use if you are going to use a really cool text, I would actually encourage you to just do it just for one word. Let's have a look through here and find something that's pretty. Make it bigger. Just so it stands out more. Make it bigger. There's a little circle down here. We can move it around. So if you just want one word to stand out, perhaps changing that into a different font instead of it all being a little bit tricky to read. Okay, going back over to the left-hand side, we've got text, then we've got photos. Now, again, this is very, this is an absolute rabbit hole that you can get lost down. So, again, I encourage you to have a look at your niche. And then all it is getting a picture that you want and then drag it over. And you've got beautiful, beautiful, beautiful imagery to use. All right. Then we've got the audio. We've talked about audio. We've got videos. Always use that that search bar. Type in your niche. Find a video that's going to work beautifully for you. And you have amazing content for your social media. Fabulous to do. Then we're going on the left-hand side, we can click on background. And you've got loads and loads of different backgrounds that you can add to your post. Try not to make it too busy though. Remember that people are scrolling very, very quickly. We need to give them value very, very quickly and not overwhelm them too much. And then you can start creating your own folders. And you'll see on the left-hand side, I've got quite a few different folders that I can create. All right, so if you're a person that does markets, actually, let's start again and I'll show you how to do this. If you're a person that does markets or has a physical store. Let's do this. Imagine that you're at the markets, you've got a special offer. In that you've changed that to suit yours up to 50% off, then wouldn't it be cool if you create a QR code? So imagine that we have, you wanted to, which you would do, sign up at businessstation.com.au. Now, did I spell that right? Generate code. We now have a QR code that people can scan. And even if you wanted to do this with your camera now, you can get your camera out. You can scan the QR code that I just created and click on the link. And that will take you to businessstation.com.au. So if you were in a market situation or if you were in a physical place, these are fantastic to use. A couple of years ago, no one knew really in Australia how to use QR codes very well, but due to COVID, everyone knows how to use QR codes. And we see them all the time now. So this is how you can create your own QR code. If you don't have a website for people to go to, why not send them to your Instagram page? Why not send them to your TikTok page? Why not send them to your Etsy shop? Why not send them to your download ebook so you can gather email addresses and you can then remarket to them through emails? So just a very, very easy way for you to create a link that goes directly to whichever URL that you want to go to. And if that URL changes, you can change it easily in Canva. All right, so that's QR codes. How are we going for time? Oh, a little bit of time. Okay, so where do we want to go now? There was one that I wanted to show you. How can I show you this? I'm just going to get a new page. Okay, so add page. We'll go up into templates. Now I want to go to something that I've uploaded previously. Let's have a look at one of my products. Okay, now if I wanted to use this product in a different scenario, but I didn't want the background around it, I would click on this picture. I would click on edit image and background remover. I would let Canva do its magic. And now we have background removed from that post. I would then download this with a transparent background. Let's do it so I can show you. And then it would download here. It's actually downloaded in a zip file. Oh, I know why. I did that wrong. Let's download that. I don't want to download all three pages. I'm going to just download the one. Thank you. Done. Transparent background. And this is, I think it's Kim. This is a great thing for you to do as well. Okay, so then I would upload that. And do you see it's uploaded just with the product? There's nothing behind the product at all. So the way that I could use this is I would go into a template. I'd possibly go into, let's have a look at skincare. Actually, a skincare product, I think, works better. And find something that I can use here. Okay, so instead of using this one here, I can put my skincare in there. That's actually not one that's going to work well. Let's do this one. So that can go. I can go into, where do I put it? Do I put it in uploads? No. I put it in that one. I can put my skincare in there using that background remover. Okay, oh, what happened? And then I'm able to change the fonts, I'm able to change the website, and you very easily have a very professional looking graphic that you can use for your social media. And then I would go along and I would probably change some of that, that text to be animated. So then I can, so I can make it into a video and it works better for the algorithms on Facebook and Instagram. Okay, isn't it fantastic, Kim? I thought you'd like that. Okay, so it really gives us the chance to create beautiful, beautiful posts that that just make our brand into a very professional looking brand. Okay, now, nice and quickly, got a couple of minutes left. I'm going to go into Canva Home, and I just want to show you Instagram Reels because Instagram Reels do work better than anything else at the moment. But people keep saying, oh, I don't want to dance, I don't want to lip sync, I don't want to have my face on camera. Let's look at all of the reels that you can create on Canva. All you would do, that's already animated for you. All you would do is put in some beautiful little graphics that you have uploaded into there of your products. And let me play that for you. You have a gorgeous, gorgeous reel to use. Let's go back. You would change it to your colors, obviously. I would crop that size, it's too large. 5 to 7 seconds. Probably even less for that one because there's not too much movement, not too much to look at. Maybe even smaller. Easy. So, so beautifully easy to create reels on Canva. I don't encourage you to do this all of the time. Reels are meant to be real and they are meant to showcase you in a more authentic way. This isn't you showing you, but this is a way, if you are terrified of video, to get started. Here's another gorgeous one. Let's play that so you can see what it looks like. That's fast, perhaps a bit too busy. You might just want to have that first one. Okay, and then you would put your products into there. All right, the other thing that is great, this is Instagram Reels, but I've found the TikTok videos give a lot more templates. So if you if you're creating an Instagram reel, the TikTok templates work beautifully, work very, very well. I would not encourage you to put these on TikTok at all. TikTok is not a Canva place. I did trial it. I practice and experiment on my own business before I come and teach you anything, and I did trial it and possibly ruined my TikTok feed, but that's okay. I need to practice these things before I share them with you. And it doesn't work. It doesn't get shown as much on TikTok as any of the other reels. If you do want to learn more about TikTok, I do teach a TikTok for business. Alrighty, let's stop sharing and see if there's any questions in here. Margaret, I'm going to get back to you if you wanted to stay online, Margaret. I'll have a little chat with you, but we are going to finish off the webinar if you don't have any other questions, and I will stop the recording and I will get back to you, Margaret, and have a little play and see what we can do. So thank you very much for joining me here. If you are live or if you are on the recording, I wish you the absolute best in your business. I love seeing businesses grow. It's one of my favorite things in life, to see people thrive and grow and be happy building their business, because I know how hard it is. I really, really do. Beautiful. Okay, thanks very much. And if you want to have a chat with me, jump into Business Station and let's have a chat about your business and get you up and running. All right, Kim, you've learned so much. Oh, I'm so glad, Kim, that's awesome news. Oh, goosebumps, I love that. You're gonna do so well. All right, I'm gonna stop the recording and chat.